McIntyre came so close to becoming the number one contender to the FCW Heavyweight Championship, and now I think we're going to hear from Drew McIntyre.
Well, he's one of these guys that will take exception to what's going on here.
Now, unlike most of the boys in the back, I don't come out here every week making false statements and accusations. My statements are made right here in this ring. And when Drew McIntyre makes a statement, everybody listens. There is nobody back there with my combination of size, strength, agility, and ability. And at 23 years old, I am the future of this business. And unfortunately for the heavyweight champion, the future is now.
Everybody taking a shot at Sheamus O'Shaughnessy. You know what I'm talking about.
That's what happens when you wear the gold.
Introducing his opponent from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 232 pounds, Johnny Curtis.
This guy right here, Johnny Curtis, has all the tools that Drew McIntyre was talking about. He's in line for the Florida Heavyweight Championship also. Great matchup.
Well, Drew McIntyre said that there's nobody in the back that matches his ability. I hope Randy Orton already left. Coming up still, we have the FCW Tag Team Championship matchup. Two out of three falls, D.H. Smith and T.J. Wilson challenging Joe Henning and Sebastian Slater. Dusty, who do you favor in this match? Who do you give the advantage to?
Well, the guy that just kicked the other guy in the face right now, that's an easy call. But I'm telling you, there's a lot of speed and ability here. These two guys, when you go down the pecking order here at FCW, who's pretty close to going to the show, both these guys are on that pecking order. So bottom line right here is a victory right here. Just moves it up a little bit more. Doesn't really hinder somebody else. But I guarantee you, see, you got size and strength and also speed there with Big Drew McIntyre. But Johnny Curtis, I call it all the time, and I say it again, he got all the tools, just need to put them in the same box.
Interesting maneuver there by Johnny Curtis, hanging onto that arm, followed up by a leg drop onto the arm of Drew McIntyre. Cover hooks the leg and a quick kick out by McIntyre.
You say that real fast, cover hooks the leg.
I've had some practice.
Good stuff. What a show we got going on, huh? Is this exciting right here at FCW?
Each and every week, wow. We're having a great time here on the Bright House Sports Network, Channel 47, as McIntyre stalks his opponent, Johnny Curtis.
Nice arm drag, brought him in there, got a counter with that, just a little bit right here. Mexican arm drag, is that right? Did I call that right?
Well, it's a Japanese arm drag, but you can call whatever you want. You're
not
the American
dream. No, that is not.
In the Hall of Famer.
A Japanese arm drag. Man. If it's in Japan, a Japanese guy do it, that's what it is.
It's just a regular arm drag, man.
Yeah, that was cool. That was a good one. Oh.
And Curtis!
Wow, caught him right in the belly. Wow, that doubled him over.
All the oxygen taken away from Johnny Curtis and Drew McIntyre. Could probably go back into the ring and win this thing by count out, but McIntyre looking to make a statement, as are all the other men and women here in Florida Championship Wrestling.
Well, I just want to, got a cover right here.
Hooks the leg, and Curtis barely kicking out.
Well, I want to say hello to all our fans on the Bright House Sports Network. You already talked about it a little bit, but across this state, I mean, you talk about on fire. FCW is in homes around the state of Florida, and it's becoming more and more popular every week because they're getting so much excitement. You never know who's going to walk in the door.
And Dusty, check it out right there. A nice, great shot there of the mouth of Johnny Curtis busted open there.
Yeah, got it busted open a little bit, but, you know, that's far from your heart. Well, you need to get down here and get tickets on Thursday nights and get here early and you get autographs from different stars. And, man, you want to be right in line, man. It's like getting a Super Bowl ticket here.
Always a great time. Snap suplex by McIntyre. We'll see how.
Better than that.
Cover hooks the leg and a kick out. We'll see how Curtis reacts to the taste of blood inside of his mouth.
Better than a Super Bowl ticket is a WrestleMania ticket, buddy. Wow. What's happening here, man?
McIntyre is perhaps taking off the turnbuckle.
Well, he tried right there. I'm telling you, you got to be careful.
Dusty mentioned WrestleMania. We're getting ready to celebrate the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania
this
year.
Look at it. Well, what's he doing? What's he doing? Yeah, it is.
McIntyre now perhaps has the turnbuckle all set to be taken off. We'll see what his plan is there. As McIntyre, butterfly suplex. And McIntyre perhaps feeling that he's in control of this one, goes for the big leg drop and misses.
He laid right on his honey. I mean, when you move and you land your honey, that ring is not soft or forgiving.
Curtis back up, forearm shot to McIntyre. These two.
He caught him both times with that forearm. That was a really weak forearm there by Drew McIntyre, but countered it with a nice kick to the abdomen.
You're right. And the cover. And the kick out by Curtis.
Hey, Edmund. How about Mike Edmund, the great Mike Edmund? Is that
I don't think that anyone's ever said the great Mike Adamley with anything.
Oh, man. Is he in a mess? Here we
and
go.
Let me ask you right now.
Yeah.
Does Drew McIntyre have what it takes to beat the FCW champion, Sheamus O'Shaughnessy?
Man, that's going to be a hard call right there. I think he does have the ability. But if you got to bring your A game. We talk about that a lot each and every night. Curtis has that ability. Everybody at FCW might have that ability, but they don't have the confidence that Sheamus O'Shaughnessy is showing and saying, you know what? I'm the best. You just seen a great look at him, and we know what he's all about. I'm talking about Sheamus O'Shaughnessy, Florida heavyweight champion.
Side Russian leg sweep by Johnny Curtis. Can this be enough? And a kick out by Drew McIntyre. McIntyre back to his feet. Hits the ropes and Johnny Curtis catches a boot right in the chest. Wow. Beautiful spinning back kick. That turnbuckle did come off, so the referee
is the referee doing a good job. Got a cat turn around that ref.
And Curtis has this thing all wrapped up. Now the cover and the counting.
Man, that's like that big fighter back in the old days had like a 19 count or something. He needs to pay a little more attention there. You know, if they...
The referee is doing maintenance in the middle of the match for some reason. And a sunset flip. Not good enough.
Turnbuckle just come off.
Turnbuckle's off again.
Yeah, he got a rope. Oh, hit him with a rope. That ain't gonna work. That ain't gonna work, boys.
And the referee's calling for the bell.
Yeah. Wow, he's choking him right now. We got a disqualification, looks like, here.
Drew McIntyre doesn't seem to care.
Wow.
Drew McIntyre choking out Johnny Curtis with the rope from the turnbuckle.
I want to see more of this. You know what I'm saying?
The winner of this match via disqualification, Johnny Curtis.
Well, I guarantee you Johnny Curtis don't want to win like that.
Drew McIntyre apparently was trying to use the ring as a weapon. The rope came off, was disqualified. Curtis picks up the victory, but don't forget.